The deeper you go, the creepier they get. You're about to travel to the darkest ocean depths and check whether this claim is true. Are the creatures living there as scary as people think? You go 120 feet down underwater. Pay close attention to the bottom under your flippers. Oh my, what's that terrifying face half hidden in the sand? That's the Northern Stargazer. You can meet this fish in the eastern United States. It buries itself in the sand until unsuspecting prey gets near. Then, the nightmarish creature electrically shocks the poor animal and dines on it. You are moving deeper to 240 feet under the surface. That's where you spot a colorful, puffy creature, no more than 1 foot long. It's the sarcastic fringehead. At first, the fish seems to be harmless. Ha, only unless it's provoked. When this animal is agitated, it opens its huge, huge mouth to fend off predators. This defense tactic is a sight to behold, both surprising and frightening. Luckily, the fish is no threat to people whatsoever. The creature you see next can comfortably live in shallow waters, but you meet it at a depth of 900 feet. You don't even need to wonder why the animal's called the Game of Thrones brittle star. Unlike starfish that slowly crawl across the seabed, this creature moves fast. It wriggles its long, flexible arms to get from point A to point B. Its body is protected by a hard calcium carbonate shell. Also called snake stars, these creatures are tiny and easily fit in nooks, cracks, and small crevices in rocks. At a much greater depth of 2,000 feet, you come across the giant squid. For a long time, it was thought to be a creature from legends rather than a real animal. The giant squid was first caught on camera in 2001, and it's exactly as big as its name implies. The creature's eyeballs are the size of soccer balls, and the squid itself can weigh up to 600 pounds. Almost 3,000 feet below the surface, you get spooked by another creepy-looking animal. It's somewhat red and rather small, no longer than 1 foot long. As you approach the creature, it looks rather docile, or maybe just indifferent. The vampire squid, that's the animal's name, looks like an umbrella with tentacles. It doesn't even produce ink, so you leave it alone. Soon after that, at a depth of 3,200 feet, you meet the cookie cutter shark. This creature is a parasite. It attaches itself to big fishes, dolphins, whales, and sometimes even people. Then, using its neatly arranged serrated teeth, it gouges out cookie-sized pieces of meat. This nasty glowing animal doesn't grow larger than 20 inches and lives in the ocean twilight zone. At a depth of 3,300 feet, the light becomes a rare and valuable thing. The animals living that far away from the surface have to evolve unusual features to survive. That's how the barrel-eye fish ended up with a transparent head and two super sensitive barrel-shaped eyes. Right now, pretty much like always, they're pointed upward, allowing the fish to see potential prey and you. Almost 4,000 feet below the surface, you see something droopy and saggy. The blobfish doesn't have a skeleton or any muscle. Its jelly-like flesh lets the creature survive incredible water pressure. Despite its appearance, the blobfish is an ambush predator. It usually lies very still on the bottom, waiting for unsuspecting prey to swim by. You go a bit deeper and spot a creature that looks particularly ghastly. The goblin shark senses prey with its snout. The creature's terrifying jaws are attached to elastic ligaments. When some animal comes too close, the shark catapults its mouth forward to catch it. If your mouth could do the same, you would be able to eat things dangling 7 inches away from your face. Even deeper than that, at 5,000 feet, you notice another member of the shark family. The frilled shark looks like an overgrown eel, but its gills are lined with red fringe at the edges, hence the name. The creature's horrifying mouth has 25 rows of razor-sharp backward-facing teeth, 300 in total. The shark prefers to hover in the water, waiting for its prey to come closer. Then, it charges at it like a snake. Suddenly, you see something glow brightly like an electric bulb. But after coming closer, you recoil in horror. The creature looks like an upgraded eel equipped with oversized teeth. That's the deep sea dragonfish that can live at a depth of 6,000 feet. Chemical processes going on inside the fish's body produce an eerie red glow. This glow is used to communicate with other fish. At the same depth, you meet another deep sea inhabitant. Its most prominent feature is its huge mouth. Thanks to it, the gulper eel can swallow its prey whole. Its stomach can expand to a terrifying size when it needs to fit something large. At a depth of 6,600 feet, you come across an angry-looking creature with a fishing rod over its head. It's the deep-sea anglerfish. The animal has an unusual dorsal spine, even though it's worn only by females. It protrudes above their mouth and has a lure on its tip, some luminous flesh that baits prey. The anglerfish has such a big mouth and its body is so pliable that it can swallow animals twice its own size. You're 7,000 feet down when you see another fish that's glowing in the dark. The black dragonfish is a sly creature. It has its light-producing organs arranged along its belly. The spooky creature also has gleaming flashlights next to its eyes. They help the animal find prey and attract potential mates. At the same depth, you also spot an enormous pill bug. But unlike the critter you can find in your garden, this one is at least 20 inches long. That's the giant isopod, and it is, indeed, related to the roly-poly, as well as crabs and shrimps. These creatures may look somewhat scary, but they're harmless. They feast on other deep-sea animals only after those have passed away. At a depth of 13,000 feet, you notice the ocean floor has become a bit fluffy. That's because it's covered with zombie worms. These creatures rarely grow to be more than 2 inches long. And still, they can break down fairly large animals, so strong the acid they produce is. The worms' feathery appearance makes them look like plants. But the truth is, these creatures munch on rock-hard bones of the world's largest animals, such as whales. The grid-eye fish almost scares you out of your mind soon after that. This creature has a pair of large greenish oval plates on the top of its head and no eyes whatsoever. Experts believe that these bony membranes detect light coming from predators, saving the fish's life. You're now 3 miles down below the surface, and that's where you spot something bizarre on the bottom. It's definitely a fish, but it's standing on the ocean floor on 3 long, rigid legs. Ah, it's the tripod fish. Curious rather than scary. This creature has adapted to the almost complete darkness by giving up on its vision. It has to rely on vibration and touch to sense prey. And then, the fish uses its fins as hands to transport food directly into its mouth. You don't have time to go any deeper before you spot the faceless fish. This slightly off-putting creature has no eyes, and its mouth, smiling a Mona Lisa smile, is underneath its body. For the first time, the faceless cusk, which is the creature's official name, was seen more than a century ago. The next time it happened was only in 2017. Once you've reached a depth of 6 miles below the surface, you see deep-sea cucumbers. These bizarre creatures are much bigger than their shallow water relatives. They spend most of their time on the seafloor. But if they need to escape predators, they are able to swim away. Deep-sea cucumbers have bright purplish coloring, tiny feet, and tentacles that surround their mouths. Cute. The question is, why do these deep-sea creatures look so scary? Life is very different there, at the bottom. Tremendous water pressure, a lack of food, and constant darkness. You have to adapt to survive in such extreme conditions.